They're a good football team, a great football team, one of the best I've seen. You know, it was a good old-fashioned whipping from all the way around. I think, you know, we just didn't play well enough to compete at times. You got to give them credit. And I think, you know, obviously as coaches, you know, falls on me to have our team ready to play better than that in a Final Four game. But I'm proud of these guys. Made a historic run. We've never been here. And I think that, you know, it's a punch in the gut, but we'll be back. That's, you know, what we want to do. We want to try to be at this level, and that's a good – that's an eye-opener for our football team and for some of our coaches to understand what it's like to compete at the highest level.
Thank you, Coach. If you have a question, please raise your hand for me to call on you. We also have local media joining us from Albany. We will start there. Adam Schinder, are you on the call?
Yep. So, Dylan, after everything this team has been through to get to this point, how hard is it to say goodbye after a game like tonight?
You know, I love everybody that I played with throughout all the years. And, yeah, we had a great year, but, I mean, just to finish like we did, just leaves a sour taste in my mouth, but I'm proud the way this team played throughout the whole year. So,
Mark Singlais.
Dylan, what makes that South Dakota State team so good?
I mean, just they're all around, just big, fast. Their O-line's probably the best O-line I've played since I've been here. Running backs are very poised, it's hard to tackle them, and their quarterback's obviously really good, up for the Walter Payton Award. So they're just all around really good. Wide receivers are making great catches.
We have News Channel Tom. Christian Harris, Albany Student Press.
Despite this being the program's worst ever loss at the FCS level, how do you guys want this historic season to be remembered overall?
Look, We had the best season in school history. We've beaten a lot of good football teams this year. This is our 15th football game. These guys have played really well. Tonight is a tough one to take for us, but you know, it doesn't diminish what they've accomplished during the season and the tough road that we have fought our way through this whole year. I'm proud of this team. You know, I you know, look, it's not obviously what we want, and give them hats off to South Dakota State, but this is a good football team. We played our tails off this year against a lot of adversity, and I'm proud of them.
Jackson Spectrum, you on?
Yeah, I'm here, Taylor. Coach Dylan, did it just seem like the cross-country traveling and the short week, did it seem at all just finally just caught up to you tonight?
No, you know, I don't know. I think people probably can make their own decisions on if they think what we had to do was an impact or not. I just think that we ran into a really good football team. Highly motivated, and when you step up to a big stage, you got to meet that level of preparation from the coach's side. You got to meet it energy side from the player side, and I think, you know, we got really beat up in the first half at times, and you know, when you add to it turnovers that we had and a kick return for a touchdown, you know, we felt like if we could have got one before the half, and then we get the ball, we might have a shot, but then, you know, and then we fumble coming out of the. Out of the break. It's just, you know, they're a good team. You can't make those kind of mistakes, and it's a disappointing loss. We'll shake it off, and we'll celebrate this year after we get home, and you know, we'll start building towards next year because that we want to come back here. We want to come back to this game.
Any questions from the media? We're back to Adam.
Yeah, Greg, you mentioned wanting to get back to this game. You know, four years ago after you got to the playoffs, won a playoff game, you ran into the COVID and kind of bumped the program back for a couple of years. What needs to be done to make sure that this program is reaching this point of a consistent level?
Well, you know, we've got to grow in many ways. You know, we have, when you see what their crowd and you see the facilities and you see the players, we have to grow as a program and understand what it's going to take. And I think on our end, you know, we've got to be able to prepare and play a better game in a tough environment like this. And, you know, but there's a lot to build off this year. I know this is a sour mark at the end of the year, and it's disappointing. But what these guys have done this year is remarkable. We've traveled I think 25,000 miles, and they've never blinked. And I think that, you know, tonight we ran into a really great football team. These guys are a great football team. So, I mean, I'm not gonna overthink it too much. Watch the tape, figure out what we got to do in recruiting, and then we'll hit the road recruiting and get ready for spring practice. Because, like I said, the challenge for us is to try to maintain the success we've had. We have a bunch of good players coming back. I think we have one of the best quarterbacks in the country coming back, and I think that we have a lot to build from.
Mark?
Greg, as you mentioned, you have a lot of talent coming back, particularly on the offense side of the ball. You lose quite a bit on defense, but do you feel like you have the pieces, the backup throwing in your program to just step in and replace those guys? Do you have to, you know, bring in some more recruits, transfers, that kind of thing?
Yeah, you know, I think one of the matchups we were worried about in this game was their defensive line. We have a young offensive line. Ozzie Hutchinson's a great player, and he's an older guy, and Will Murad. But we have a true freshman playing center, a freshman playing right tackle, and a redshirt sophomore playing left guard who played his first game about 8 weeks ago. So, you know, that was a matchup. We could not run the football, you know, and I think that, you know, we know we're going to be better at that as these guys mature, and we're obviously going to add, you know, I think in the last – year and a half, 2 years, you know, I'm not a person that loves the portal in the sense of what it means and what it is for what we're teaching kids. But at the end of the day, we're going to be good in the portal because we've done a great job identifying talent and bringing people in, and we're going to continue to do that. I mean, I'm excited about our future. I'm excited about our football team. I'm going to miss some of these guys because they're amazing. This guy here has just been one of the best players I've ever been around. And was not the result obviously we wanted, but you know, we're looking forward to the future. I cannot wait to get back on the road recruiting with what we've accomplished, and we're going to move forward.